what I love and what I'm passionate about is finding better ways of teaching programming, especially to kids. I really love this term, chocolate-covered broccoli. And I think that's what educational video games have been up until now. I mean, it really has been, oh, look, it's a game, just kidding. You can play for a second and now go solve this math problem for 10 minutes. The big difference between a chocolate-covered broccoli game and a real immersive educational video game is that you shouldn't have to stop playing to go do the learning and then stop learning to go do the playing. So the first level of CodeSpells that we ever built was literally just this dark forest with one gnome, one crate, and one spell. And we actually tested it out. We had 40 middle school girls, and we just kind of gave them tasks to do and said, try to get the crate to do this and try to get it to do that. So we started to understand how kids would interact with this. After that, we decided to add in a spell book. And this spell book really was our sneaky way of putting in a textbook into the game. The students have a problem in front of them. You have to figure out how to collect all the bread. Now you've got this spell book as a resource, why don't you go look into that and see what you could use to be able to collect all the bread? Using Scratch, Alice, and CodeSpells are really important because what they do is they provide a visual context for the programming. The students make some change in the program and immediately can see that effect of that change. Usually what I'll have the kids do is some paperwork first. And what I found is that getting the kids to actually write the spells down on paper, it's a slower process and they actually think about it more. And then when they go onto the computer, they actually can write the spells very, very quickly. Pair programming is an industry standard practice. You have two people on one computer. And the driver is in charge of the keyboard and mouse and really focuses on the low-level things, typing everything in and getting everything to work. The navigator is then able to focus on kind of the higher level things. Not only is it an industry standard practice that we want them to start working on, but because they have to articulate what it is that they want, they start to use the language of computer science a lot more expert-like. We have them switch every 2 minutes just because it's all about building something as a team. Collaboration, communication, they're not often related with programming or computer scientists, but they're absolutely critical to software. Depending on the school you go to, if there's an instructor there who's really passionate about computer science, they might have a course. Otherwise, it's generally not within the curriculum. And there's a lot of reasons for this. One of them is that the people who are teaching don't have that programming expertise. And so one of the things that I'd like to do is come up with curriculums and softwares such that they can teach in a classroom of 30 kids without having to be programming experts. And we really like to engage the kids in what we like to call STEAM, science, technology, engineering, art, and math. Everything related to STEM, you're gonna have to have some creativity. It's also really important to show that especially computer science can be expressive. Have the kids engaging in solving problems, but not just contrived here, build a calculator that we've had for however many years, but instead, let's build something you're interested in. Let's try to make a video game. Let's make a comic strip, but have each block be moving around, and when you click on the cat, it meows. Getting them to be self-motivated and excited about what they're doing so that they want to go home and keep doing it. And it's not just something that they do in the classroom.
So what do you think? Are there other ways we can use video games in the classroom? Let us know in the comments below. And if you want to learn more about the ways that scientists use art, watch this video here.